You are who you are. Yesterday, today, and forevermore. What you say is what you do. You never fail, you never change. You are faithful till the end. Faithful God, I worship you. I worship you. You're too faithful to fail me. You're too faithful to disappoint me. You've proven yourself in my life, and I've come to realize you're too faithful to fail me. You're too faithful to fail me. Oh Jesus, you're too faithful to disappoint me. You've proven yourself in my life, and I've come to realize you're too faithful to fail me. Hey, da, da, da. To leave me halfway, yeah. What what you start, you always finish. Lord, I've come to realize that you are too faithful to fail me. What you start, you always finish. Lord, I'm here to testify, you're too faithful to fail. Yesterday, today, and forevermore. What you say is what you do. You never fail, you never change. You are faithful till the end. Faithful God, I worship you. I worship you. You're too faithful to fail me. You're too faithful to disappoint me. You've proven yourself in my life, and I've come to realize you're too faithful to fail me. Too faithful to fail me. Oh Jesus, you're too faithful to disappoint me. You've proven yourself in my life, and I've come to realize you're too faithful to fail me. Hey, da, da, da.
You say is what you do. realize you are too loving to leave me. Yes, Lord. Indeed, he is too faithful to fail us. You are too faithful to fail me, oh Jesus. Yes, Lord. You are too faithful to disappoint us, Daddy, Lord, because you've proven yourself in our lives. We are here to testify. You are too faithful to fail us. What you say, what you do, oh Lord, oh, tell him he's too faithful to fail us. We are come again just to tell him how faithful he is to us, how faithful he has been to you. See, throughout the problem, everything that is happening in our lives, he is standing by you and me. He is being too loving to lead you and me halfway. It does not matter what we faced last night. It does not matter the challenges. It does not matter that we don't have solution right now, but we know that he has proven himself in our lives over and over again, that we can trust that he is too committed to you, your family. He's too committed to me, my family. He is too consistent to you, my family, to fail us. He cannot fail us, because what he starts, he will finish. If he has woken us up this morning, he will make sure that we are good, despite what we had last night. Despite the issues of life, despite issues at work, despite anything at all, our health, he has come to tell us this morning that he is too faithful to fail us. Have you just come to realize that he is too faithful? Well, it's not too late, because this morning we will start by thanking him. We will start by praising him, by giving him thanks for his faithfulness, for his steadfast love, for his commitment to us, to you and to me. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Good morning. Good morning. Good afternoon, because I don't know where you have logged in from. Thank you very much for coming to share this morning with the Holy Spirit, for making the decision that this is where you want to be. Thank you. And I pray that it will be a very beautiful and sweet experience with the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. Please get your pen and get your paper. You know how we do it. Get them handy so that you can make notes as the Spirit, you know, as the word comes. You can just jot it down and say, this is mine. And you hold on to it and you run with it for the rest of the remaining week and the week to come and the months to come. Praise the Lord. On behalf of our senior pastors, I, Kate Ogundemorim, I'm welcoming you on this platform to fellowship with God, you know, to be with God, alone with God this morning, just you and him, not you and me, but you and God. You are welcome. Our pastors, they have sent their special greetings, Pastors Andrew and Yemi Adeleke, and they are sending you a warm greeting and said, whatever it is that has brought you to this platform, you will not go back the same. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm excited, and I want you to know that this thing that you're going to receive this morning, this, you know, communication you're going to receive today from the Holy Spirit, don't let it be you alone. Wake up your children. Wake up your neighbors. Wake up your friends. Call them, text them, and say, the hour has come. Let them come and experience the same thing, and it will be done in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us start by thanksgiving. You know, we started again. We started before to say to the Lord, you are too faithful to fail us. You are too committed to lead us halfway. You are too consistent, because what you say, That is what you do. But we know that. So let's go and thank him and say, thank you, God, for your steadfastness in our lives. Your steadfastness in my family, in my life. It does not matter the rain. You are still there. Let us begin to thank him. Let us begin to thank him. In Lamentations 3:22, he says, tell us, he says, the steadfast love of the Lord, it never ceases. It doesn't go away. It is there. His mercy never comes to an end. It doesn't come to an end. It is there. You know, another thing that fascinates me, he says, they are new every morning, just like this morning. They are new. They are new. He reassured us that great is his faithfulness. Let us thank him. Let us give him praise and say, thank you for your steadfast love upon me, upon my children. Thank you for the privilege, oh God, for partaking in your steadfast love, which never ceases. It does not cease, never ceases. It will never leave us. It is there for us. So we thank you. It is not the love of man. It is not the love of my neighbor. This is the love, the agape love from above. Oh my God, let's just bow before him and say, thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you for your mercies that never come to an end upon my life. Thank you for reassuring us that they are renewed every morning. Just as we have woken up, you have renewed it. What type of insurance is this that does not go away? We thank you, O God. We give you praise. We give you praise. Thank him in advance. Thank him. Even if you are not feeling the love now, thank him in advance and say, I know, Father, that whatever it is that is burdening my heart, whatever it is that is making me not to feel the love of God right now, I know it will go away. I know you will make it right. I know you will fix it for me. And therefore, I want to thank you in advance of that which you are going to do. I want to thank you in advance of that hospital appointment. I want to thank you because your steadfast love will go with me. Your mercies will never come to an end. I want to thank you, oh God, for that burden. I want to thank you for that issue in my life. I want to thank you for that uncertainty. I want to bless you. I want to lift you. Because I know that you have promised me that it's going to be okay. And that is why I am here, because I know it will be okay. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. That situation may be ugly right now. It may be ugly right now. It may be ugly right now. It's okay. I get it. I understand it. But in the book of Isaiah 43:2, when we are promised, that when we pass through waters, when we pass through waters, that he will be with us. And when we go through the rivers, that this river will never overwhelm us. Do you believe? Do you understand? Do you accept it? Is that what you feel? Is that what you're feeling right now? Is that what brought you here? Well, then thank him. Then give him praise. Give him praise. Father, I thank you. I thank you for my home. I thank you for my life. I thank you for my children. I thank you for my husband. I thank you for my loved ones. I thank you for my neighbor. I thank you for House of Praise. I thank you for my pastors. I thank you for my ministers. I thank you for my friends. I thank you for everything, oh God. I thank you for the air that I breathe. I thank you for the birds on the tree. I thank you, oh God, for making everything beautiful for us. I exalt you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Thank you for being our helper. Thank you for being my helper. Thank you for not allowing the flood, allowing the river, yes, to engulf us. I thank you, Father. Thank you because you're my helper. In Hebrews 13 says, the Lord is my helper. Yes, you are. And I will not fear. What can a man do to me? What can they do to me? Because you are with me. You are my helper. You are my helper. Surely you are my helper. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. And I will tell my soul, brothers and sisters, let's tell our souls. Psalm 33 verse 20 says, tell your soul to wait for the Lord, for he is your help and your shield. My soul, wait for the Lord, for he is your help and your shield. Thank you for perfecting everything that concerneth me, concerneth my life, concerneth my home. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Are you thanking him? We cannot thank him enough. Thank you. Thank you. Look at the woman with the issue of blood for 12 years. 12 years. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just keep 12 years. The Bible tells us that she's visited, you know, gone for treatment. It's not going away. He was there challenging her, tormenting her for 12 years. Look how he was, you know, taken away in a glimpse of an eye. He just touching Jesus's garment and all became well. And this is the Lord that we serve. He might be there. He might be stagnant in your view. He said it has been there for a long time. But you know, say it this morning. Say it. It is done. Say it is done. It is done. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Momo that situation. I don't know what it is. Momo it. Say it in your heart. And call the name of Jesus and say, it is finished. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for we know it is finished. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. As we go before him this morning, we're going to bow before him this morning and say, Father, we have come the way we are with the dirty garment. Is there any way we have a dent in our garment? We have come, oh God, to ask for forgiveness. Let us even thank him for always admitting us. Let us thank him for always admitting us and granting us the privilege to receive forgiveness. I mean, for always being on standby to say, come, come and tell me, I will forgive. I am here for you. Thank you, Lord, for always giving us opportunity. In so many ways in our lives, when we have gone astray, even to our parents, to go to our parents to apologize, we have to go through an uncle or go through our senior siblings to say, please go and ask dad to forgive me. But no, we don't need to go through anyone. He said, I am on standby. Come, I will forgive you. And that is what we're going to do this morning. Let's pray a prayer of repentance. Let us pray. Let us not feel that it's our right. He must forgive us. He must forgive us. Rather, let us go to the Lord and say, thank you for not abandoning us. Thank you for not abandoning us to our mistakes. You know, when a child has brought out what the child has eaten and the child is lying down and you have not gone quickly to bring that child and clean the child off from the mess, it can choke. But here we are. We've got the master who is not leaving us with our mistake, to choke with our mistakes. He said, no, come and offload it. Come and tell me. So let us tell him this morning and say, Father, every mistake, every sin, every step that we have taken, everything that we have done that has not pleased you, this morning, oh God, I said, for me, forgive me. For my family, forgive us. For my neighbor, forgive us. For our neighbor, for our community, forgive us. For the body of Christ, forgive us. For the nations, forgive us, oh God. Lord, convict me, convict us of sin. Help us to accept your mercy this morning in the name of Jesus. I hope you're praying. You don't have to pray exactly how I'm praying. Just pray as the Holy Spirit leads you. Father, I humble myself this morning. Father, I humble myself on behalf of my household, on myself and my community, even my neighbor, even at my workplace. Father, I know that we sometimes step outside what you want us to be, who you want us to be. We are ready to repent. Help us, oh God. Help us, O God, wash away our sins, purify us, and help us to turn from these sins, O Lord, my Father. In the name of Jesus, let your compassion fall over us. Is there anybody amongst us that wants to experience what Zacchaeus experienced? That even as we are here, we don't even know our Lord Jesus Christ, that he, as our personal Savior. This is the opportunity. If you have a family member that you are still trying to convince to understand that God is God, this is the opportunity. Zacchaeus, the Bible told us that Zacchaeus was so desperate. He had everything, but he was so desperate to know Jesus. He tried. The crowd said, no, who is stopping you this morning from saying, Father, I am here. I want to know you. Zacchaeus did not allow anything to stop him. He climbed the tree. He ran. He focused on the way where Jesus would be passing, and he climbed the tree just to know Jesus, just to know him. Because the Bible said that Jesus was seeking, and Zacchaeus was seeking too. This morning, he's seeking. Jesus is here and he's seeking. He's seeking for you and me. He's seeking for that soul that is longing for him. Just touch your heart and say, I am here, God. I am here. Call me like you call Zacchaeus. Call me. Notice me. Notice me. Call me by my name and I will be okay. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. And if you have prayed that prayer, welcome to the body of Christ. Let us pray for our pastors and our churches and our nations. Let us pray for our, first of all, let us pray for our ministers, our pastors, that the Lord will continue to uphold all of them. Let us use our senior pastors as our point of contact. Pastors Yemi and Andrew Adeleke. Let us remember all the pastors in the house of praise, in every church, all of the churches that you know. Let us ask God that he should continue to uphold them in this work that he's called them, in this missionary work, to direct their ways and to give them guidance and clearance in their work, in whatever they do. For the Lord, let us ask God to lay hand upon their health, to lay hand on them and give them good health. Good health. Let their health not fail them in the name of Jesus. Recently, my pastor, Pastor Yemi, turned 60. And I had somebody say, this is a miracle. This is a miracle that she's alive to turn 60. It's a thing to thank God, because the enemy thought she wouldn't make 60. And that is the same prayer we're praying for all ministers of God, because we know that the enemy wants to terminate them. The enemy wants to take their life. He wants to quench their lights before they get to what God is calling them to accomplish. So we decree and we declare this morning, and we say that our pastors shall not suffer ill health. In the name of Jesus, their health will not fail them. The ministers, the missionaries, wherever they are, that their health will not fail them. In the name of Jesus, their homes, the Lord will give them peace in their homes, in their daily endeavors. They will find peace. They will have integrity. They will walk in integrity at all times. In the name of Jesus, God will protect them. God will protect the missionaries from every spiritual attack. From every spiritual attack. In the name of Jesus, that they will stand firm in the armor of God and resist the enemy. Father, we are thanking you. We are thanking you for all our church leaders, for all our church leaders, for all our godly counsels, even our friends, those that are in the battlefield, those that are missionaries, those that are going in the places, in the secret places where nobody else will want to go, but they are taking chances for Christ. We thank you, Lord, because we know they will finish well. In Jesus' mighty name. as we pray for our churches. We said, Father, let the body of Christ continue to be a strong tower and a refuge to all that run into them. In the name of Jesus, the persecuted ones that are being persecuted for their faith, for what they believe in. Father, we remember them this morning. We said, Father, rescue them from the fowler. Rescue them, oh God. Rescue them. We remember in particular our missionaries. Our missionaries in the battlefield. Those that are going in those secret places, in the dangerous places. Father, we said, let your hands uphold them. Let your hand, for each time they leave, they will say to their family, God be with you until we meet again, because they know that danger is ahead of them, but they are going anyway for Christ. We said, Father, uphold them. Father, protect them. Protect their families. Protect their families. Protect them, oh God, from the eye of the enemy. In the name of Jesus, Father, reunite your church family. Unite us with love and truth. For us to grow spiritually, let the body of Christ grow spiritually, and for strength in times of trial. In times of trial, Father, let there be strength. Release strength. Release unity. Release love. Release the truth, the light, the word of God to overcome every trial in the body of Christ. In the name of Jesus, for our nations, we said, Father, raise godly leaders. Raise godly leaders. Father, raise godly leaders. Those that they have the fear of God in them. Father, Lord, we want to repent. Let us repent. Let us repent. Let us repent for our nations. Let us repent and ask God for every iniquities. If you, everywhere you turn, it's like you should close your eyes. It's like you're thinking, and it's getting worse by day. People, they have total disregard for God. They just do what they like. Let us say, pray that God should please forgive the iniquities of all the nations. Let us use the United Kingdom as a point of contact and say, the land where our feet are, the United Kingdom. Touch your feet on the ground and said, we stand on this ground and we pray for mercy. We pray for mercy. We pray for mercy for United Kingdom. We pray for mercy for all the nations all over the world. For Africa, we pray for mercy. For Asia, we pray for mercy. For every European country, we pray for mercy. All of them, mention them one by one. Mercy, oh God, let your mercy abound in the name of Jesus. Let us ask God for wisdom and fear of God upon our government in all levels of leadership. In all levels of leadership. Godly leaders, we pray. Oh God, let the godly leaders lead in the seven spheres of influence. The economy, the family, the arts and media, religion, education. Let us pray that let godly leaders occupy these seats and bring forth the fruit that will be rewarding for this nation, that will run with the heartbeat of a great nation, of what God has in mind for each nation. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you. Let us pray for our youths. There is no nation without effective youths. We pray for our youths. We said, Father, because they are the next in line. They are the ones that will take this nation, each nation, from strength to strength. Therefore, we pray that the Lord will give them sense of direction in the name of Jesus. He will snatch them from the hands of the enemy and give them focus and direction in everything they do. We cancel the spirit of dying early termination of their lives. We said no, in the name of Jesus. Our youth will live long because they will have a better and brighter future wherever they are, all over the world, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. We cannot forget families. Let us pray for every broken and dysfunctional homes. Let us begin to pray and say, Father, mend every broken and dysfunctional home in the name of Jesus. Heal every family, whether those that are here and those that are not here, wherever they are, Father, both physical, spiritual, and emotional healing. Oh, Lord, especially where these families are hurting for what they are experiencing. We don't know. We don't know. Even we that are here, is there any way in our life that we are experiencing hurt, that we need a touch, physical, spiritual, and emotional in all areas of our lives, Father? Please help us. Touch us, oh God. Whatever we are going through, whatever we are passing through, individually, collectively, as family, in the nation, in our neighborhood, Father, touch us, touch our loved ones. Help us, oh God. Help us, Father. Help us, God, in your special way. Wherever we are, wherever they are right now, wherever, whosoever, whether they are here, whether they are not here, Father, let the, for the reason of this prayer, let your touch, your healing, your balm of Gilead touch them, suit them. In the name of Jesus, so anyone that has been violated and they're still being violated in families, Father, we present them before you. Father, we say, Jesus, don't let them be the way they are. Save them. Save them from this situation. In the name of Jesus, every child that is placed in a family where they are being violated, Father, we remember them. In the name of Jesus, Jehovah, send a helping hand to them. Families that cannot afford food, families that cannot afford shelter, families that are going through turmoil. I don't know what it is, but Jesus, you know. We may not know, but you know. We leave them before you this morning. We lift ourselves before you. We lift our families before you. We lift our children before you. We lift our loved ones before you. We said, Father, whatever that needs to be fixed, whatever that needs to be fixed, whatever that needs to be fixed, oh God. Some families are experiencing the journey of prodigal children. Child number one, no. Child number two, no. Child number three, no. And they are saying, Lord, why is our own different? Why is it not? Why is my own not like that person? Father, this morning, speak to them and say, be still. That you have not forgiven us. You have not forgotten 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 them. You will come. You will come. Let their hearts be calm. Let them find peace and look up to you, knowing that at the right time, in your time, you will fix it. This is the promise you gave us, that you will never fail. You will never disappoint us. You are too consistent. You are too committed. You are too faithful to fail every family that is looking up to you, oh God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. As many as are suffering mental health illness, as many as are hearing voices, let us leave them before the throne of grace. I said, Father, Lord, the word, we bind the word, the voice, the little voice, the devilish voice that is speaking in their minds, that is speaking. We bind them, we subdue them. We say, let Holy Spirit, let them hear the word, the voice of the Holy Spirit from this morning onwards. Father, we bind the spirit of that little voices that speaks even to children and confuse them and call itself mental illness. We come against it in the name of Jesus. We come against this device of the enemy in the name of Jesus. I thank God because I know you are praying. I thank God because I know you are praying with me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I know we are praying. Blessed be your holy name. I want to lead you, ask you, brothers and sisters. I want to ask you to put your hand in your chest this morning. Put your hand in your chest in the name of Jesus. And ask the Lord to give you one testimony this week, whether you have asked or not, ask him not to leave nor forsake you nor your loved ones this week. I said, Father, I am here. Thank you, Lord, because I know you will give me testimony. I know you will give me, you will embarrass me with testimony. I will come back on Monday on this platform to testify. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, as we receive this blessing. I receive on behalf of myself. I receive on behalf, pray, tell him. I receive on behalf of my family. I receive on behalf of my children. I receive on behalf of my loved ones, my friends, my neighbor. I receive that testimony in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. If you can, place your hand in your ears. Place your hand in your ears if you can. If you cannot, you can pronounce it. You can say it. You command your ear and say, listen, oh ear, listen to me. You will not hear any bad news. I will not receive any bad news. Tell your ear what you do not want to hear and tell your ear what you want to hear. It is Holy Spirit is here. Ear, oh ear. I will not receive any bad news concerning my children, concerning my marriage, concerning my home, concerning my husband, concerning my siblings, concerning my job, concerning my loved ones, concerning House of Praise, concerning my pastors, concerning, oh God, my friends. I said no bad news. I will not receive any bad news concerning my siblings in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for this year. You will hear good news. You will hear good news. You will give me good news from this day onwards. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Thank you, Lord. You touch your eye if you can. You touch your eyes. You said, this eye, I mean, tell this eye what you don't want this eye to see. And I'm telling my eyes that you will not see evil. You will not see evil. You will not weep in sorrow. I, oh eyes, listen, you will not. You will not see evil. I will not see evil with my eyes. My family will not see evil with their eyes. In the name of Jesus, we will open these eyes and we will see the goodness of the Lord upon our eyes. We will see, upon our lives, we will see the blessings of God. What we will see is the light, the shining light of God. You will not, these eyes produce tears of hurt in the name of Jesus. I will not witness what will break me down with my eyes. I will not witness on behalf. I stand on behalf of myself, my family, my children, my household, my friends, the body of Christ. We will not experience, we will not see evil in the name of Jesus from this day moving forward. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. I touch my mouth. If you want to touch your mouth, touch it. It's your mouth. You can touch it and touch you. I said, mouth, oh mouth. Mouth, oh mouth. Begin to speak what you want from this mouth. Mouth, I said, you will not speak word of evil. Will not come from this mouth. God, help me. Help me. Season my words. Season my thought. Season my word. Whatever that comes from this mouth, let it be seasoned. Let it be for the glory of the Lord. Give me wisdom from this mouth. I will speak the word of wisdom from this mouth. I will speak the words that will come out of this mouth will glorify the Lord. It will glorify the Lord. It will not defy the Lord, but it will glorify him. Thank you, Jesus. This mouth, I will not use it to weep. I will not use it to weep. I will not weep for my children. I will not weep for my family. I will not weep in the name of Jesus. Mouth or mouths. From this day onwards, I sanctify you. I sanctify you with the blood of Jesus. You will speak the word that brings, that glorify God in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord. We are still going. You touch your heart and begin to speak to this heart and said, heart, oh heart, you will not harbor hatred. You will not harbor evil. You will not harbor hatred. You will not harbor envy. You will not. You will only reproduce love in the name of Jesus. You will reproduce love. You will not harbor pain. You will not harbor hurt in any way in the name of Jesus. I open you up and I command you to accept the Holy Spirit to live in this heart. to live here. That's where I want this Holy Spirit to live, in this heart, and to minister to me regularly, every minute, every second, in the name of Jesus. This heart will not be, it will not be harboring evil, in the name of Jesus, because my body is a sanctuary of God. Thank you, Jesus. Let's command our body. Let's remind our body that our body is a temple of God. In the name of Jesus, it represents God. Every affliction in my body, speak to your body. I don't know what is in this body that you feel that is an alien. Whatever it is, leg pain, every disease that is in this body, you do not represent Christ, because this body is a temple of God. And I stand in awe of God this morning, and I command this body. Use your body to represent the body of your children, the body of your husband, your wife, your family members. Say it and say, Lord, I decree and I remind you enemy, that this body is a sanctuary of God. Therefore, you cannot torment this body. You cannot. Sickness cannot dwell in this body. We cannot dwell in the body of my loved ones. I cannot service sickness in this body. You are a trespasser. Oh, you pain in my body. Oh, you sickness, whatever they call you, you do not have a name. I am reminding you that from this moment, from this day onwards, you will not reside in this body that represents me, represents the Holy Spirit, represents my family. You will not represent, you will not be here. You are not meant to be in my body. Pack and go. You are evicted right this moment, because this body is a sanctuary of God. And I plead the blood of Jesus upon my body, that there is no sickness that will remain in this body, that the blood of Jesus will flush them out. Flush them. Is it the spirit of anger? Is it the spirit of whatever it is that is in this body that is not of God? This morning, we command you. We said, go, because this body is not your place of residence. It belongs to God. My children belongs to God. My home belongs to God. Every intruder, it's time for you to go, for there is no place in this body, in this home for you. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Speak to your mind. Speak to your mind. Speak to your mind. Mind, oh mind. Do you have any family member that they are saying, oh, because they are old, they are losing their mind? Let us speak to our mind and say, mind, oh mind. We speak to you. We will not lose our minds in the name of Jesus. In that which the enemy has brought our way and thinking that he will use this to dysfunction our minds, we claim victory right now in the name of Jesus. And we say that we will not lose our minds. My family member will not lose their mind. My mother will not lose her mind. I will not lose my mind. My children will not lose their mind. And whatever they hear, they will remember. Whatever they know, they will remember. Remember, in the name of Jesus, I will not think twice before I remember what I ought to know. In the name of Jesus, mind, I speak to you. I speak to you. I speak to you that you will obey. You will comply. You will be sound. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, mind, oh mind, I said you will be perfect. The mind of my loved ones, the thinking of my loved ones, they will not live in forgetfulness. They will not live, I can't remember. No, it is not our passion. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I speak to the mind of even people that are not here. We speak to you. We said, yes, you will be of sound mind. We will be of sound mind. Peradventure, you are thinking, they say, no, they didn't say anything, because the Lord is saying it this morning. He's reverting it this morning. He is saying, who is that has spoken and it comes to pass if I have not said so? This morning, we claim it. We said the Lord has said, for the Lord says so, and it shall be in the name of Jesus. Not just us. Let us begin to pray. Let us begin to remember those that are in the hospital. Let us, especially the elderly ones that are in a place where even when their loved ones come to greet them, they don't remember them anymore and their mind is being fiddled with. Let us begin to lift them before the throne of grace and say, God, touch their minds. Touch their minds. Touch their mind. Change their situation. There's nothing too hard for you to do. There's nothing too hard for you to do. We know that you can do all things. That what you cannot do, it's not in existence. Therefore, Lord, we pray. We extend our prayers to everyone in the hospital that is suffering from the disaster that this mind, this deterioration of thinking, of how they perceive things, oh God, and they're giving it name. We said, Father, right now, as we pray, is there any family member that is going through that? Is there any family member that is going through this check? Oh Lord, we said, Father, touch their minds so they can feel whole again. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. 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 I'm not released. I think we have to go back to pray for health in the name of Jesus. I know we have said that this body is the sanctuary of God. Let us go back. This is now your space, your personal space to command at your own pace, to speak to everything. If there is nothing for you to command, the sickness, the illness in your body for you to command, please ask God to remember one person. Remember one person, maybe your neighbor, maybe in your workplace, that person that has been on sick leave, that has not returned to work. That is what Christianity is all about. It's about love, sharing love. Maybe in the body of Christ, maybe there is someone that has been that is bereaved, someone that has lost their loved ones and they are hurting. You may think they are not sick. Yes, they are. The hurting of the mind, the hurting of their heart, the pain that they receive, let us lift them. If you don't have any to say, just remember people that are losing their minds. Just remember someone this morning and place them before the throne of grace. Father, filter us. Filter our bodies. Filter us. Give us sound health. All these days, the amount of the type of sickness we are hearing, the things we are hearing from our mouth, from the mouth of the doctors, you know, names, the sickness, the types of illness, when they pronounce it, you're wondering, I haven't had this one before. Father, whomever that is going through this pain of sickness, even in my body, Father, is there anything that is in my body? The leg pain, every sickness, every declared sickness in my body, every pronunciation about anything that is not meant to be in this body, that the enemy has brought in this body, I stand as a point of contact to God for all my loved ones, my family, the body of Christ, my neighbors, those that are in the hospital. I stand as a point of contact, Father. I said this morning, rewrite the reports in the name of Jesus. Rewrite the report. Give us a clean slate of health, oh God. Give us a clean slate of health, oh God. We remember all the children, so many children. We go into, let your angels, oh God, carry these prayers and move into Children's Hospital, Great Ormond Hospital, St. Queen's Mary, all the hospitals where children are lying helpless, where they are suffering. Some are suffering cancer, as small as they are. Children are now suffering stroke. Some are on life support machine. Father, wherever they are, some adults, they are going, young adults, teenagers, they are going through one sickness or the other. Father, for the reason of this prayer, we said, Lord, remember them, touch them and deliver them from the snares of the fowler. In Jesus' mighty name, heal our home, heal our home, heal our land, heal our nations, heal our workplaces, heal us in any way that pleases you, oh God. We thank you, return all praises to you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. So just use the next 1 minute and pray. There are young girls who have been violated in so many ways. Their bodies have been tampered with, people that they have no right to do so, but they have done that to them. And they are living in fear of what they haven't done. They are the victim. They are the victim, and they are now treating themselves as if they are the perpetrator. Some of them are cutting themselves. Some of them are hating themselves. Some of them are living in constant blame with their family. Let us just leave them and say, Father Lord, as many as there are, these teenagers, our young children that have been violated in any form, in any way, that their minds are now downcasted, that they are now feeling depressed. They are now feeling depressed. They cannot open their curtains. Father, for the reason of this prayer, we said, Lord, we stand in agreement with heaven. And we said, release them from this bondage and let them feel loved again, if not by man, by Christ, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. The little time that is left, we can stay here and pray and pray. Let us go into giving. We are going to go into giving to the Lord. Give, it shall be given unto you. Good measure, shaking together and running over. Sister, give, give, give. The details are now up. And I'm singing this song. I will not be singing it right, but I want you to give with joy and happiness. It shall be given unto me, good measure shaking together and running over. Brother, give, give. It shall be given unto you, good measure shaking together and running over. Give to the Lord, because he shall be given unto you back. Good measures, shaking together, running over. Hallelujah. If you look on the screen, you will see the details telling you how to give, the ways to give. We are giving unto the Lord. For our prayers this morning, they are all answered. For our God is good all the time. You are too faithful to fail us. He is too committed to let us down. He is too consistent. Oh, Father, we thank you for giving us the opportunity to give. Thank you, Lord, for anyone here that wants to give, but they are not able to give. They have one reason or the other why they cannot give this morning. Our giving is for, is also for them. Our giving is also, should be taken as, because we are one in Christ. Don't feel anyhow, because God knows. We thank you. And if you finish giving, let us just raise whatever you have used to give and pray and say, Lord, as we have given this morning, let good measures shaking together fall upon us. Let it be running over, running over, running over, running over. Ha! That even the person next to us will feel that, something has happened. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. We cover all our prayers this morning with the blood of Jesus. We cover our giving with the blood of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We bless your name for giving us opportunity. We started with prayer. We started with thanksgiving. We are going to end with thanksgiving, because, you know, you are with us. You sent your Holy Spirit to be with us. Anything could have gone wrong during the course of this prayer. There could have been power cut. Yes, yes, yes. There could be power cut. Don't say this is England. There's no power cut, because there can be power cut. The other day, some people in some part of Kent, they didn't have light. So if there's power cut, we would have been running up and down. But he did not allow it to happen. There could have been devices, you know, for some of us that don't know how to operate these things. There could have been a devices crisis, but he kept everything in. We're not taking it for granted. Thank you, Lord. I'm afraid that's all we have for you. As we continue to wish our senior pastor, Mrs. Pastor Yemi Adeleke, it continues to be her birthday week. Hallelujah. And we are still going to celebrate her on Saturday. She's worshiping for 6 hours. What a great worshiper. Come worship with us. I think you need an IV. So check our line to see whether there's still space. God bless you. If not, we see you on Sunday at House of Praise, Camberwell, where we'll be doing dancing, doing Thanksgiving, and thanking God for a life that he has spent. We say happy birthday to you again, Ma. God bless you for coming, everyone. God bless you, and I hope you've been blessed. Thank you. God bless you. Whatever you do today, remember that there are people that need Christ. Go out there and evangelize. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. He is too faithful to fail us.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the his soul.